How much do you use your intuition, or do you notice it, but then do whatever you were going to do and then realize afterwards, oh, I should have done that. I knew I should have done that. How often have you said that? And yet you didn't, right? You didn't listen to your intuition. That's what happens more often than not.
You know, I define success as happy, healthy, wealthy. And I don't think I've run into anybody, in business or otherwise, who was not internally directed more than externally. In other words, they paid more attention to their intuition, their internal leader, or your leader within, as I call it. And so, I mean, to answer your question, when I looked at FedEx and how we started, I mean, Fred Smith was probably one of the most intuitive people I know and one of the most inner-directed. He would always ask for opinion, but in the end, he would make up his mind. And when you look at the beginning of FedEx, there wasn't a need out there. I mean, there wasn't anything. I mean, you ask people whether they needed overnight service, they said, nah, I got, you know, plenty of time. I'll put a stamp on an envelope instead of spending $5, I'll spend 12 cents. And so, but his intuition said, yeah, there's a need. People are going to need faster and faster service over time. And so that was his intuition talking in the face of nearly every expert at the time saying, you can't have an airline for packages. It won't pay for itself. There's no need in the marketplace. And in the beginning, with four packages the first night, it was pretty clear that they were right and he was wrong. But his intuition held strong.
So
it was a combination of that intuition with rational thinking that got us there, I guess is a good answer. Employees. Like each city had to start with either 6 to 10 employees to unload and make deliveries. So one guy would go take care of the airplane, the other guy would go take care of the place, another guy would call on the local Hertz office and make sure we had the airplanes and our logos on them and so forth. And Lindy was responsible for hiring the people. So he would go to a bar at happy hour, about 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and when things got really rolling, he'd stand up on a chair. This was Lindy, as you well know. And he'd clink a glass and get everybody's attention, and he'd say, hey, does anybody need a job in town here? We're hiring. New company, come to town. Come see me. And he'd sit down at a table, and he'd have people fill out applications, and he'd actually make five or six offers that day and really get a commitment from the people. Now, one of the people he hired, I'm trying to think of his name, ended up to be the CEO of E-Trade. And the guy started as a baggage handler in Los Angeles, I think, that the guy that Lindy hired as a cargo handler.
Well, I mean, he hired several of them, what became vice presidents, the senior vice presidents of FedEx,
exactly.
Right? But he just knew. So can you tell me a bit about that? Let's see if we can get into Lindy's head. How was, you know, you? I'm sure you talked to him about this, about how did he get that read on people?
Lindy had, and this goes to intuition, Lindy had a sense of people. And he was the only guy I ever knew that could fire you and you would thank him for it.
So,
and that was his intuitive ability to know people, know what made them happy, only by asking questions that were intuitively driven.